Welcome to Mobile Mix. This week we're in the heart of Transylvania to see how smart city deployments are transforming this historic town into one of the smartest around. We spoke to the city manager who's been working on the project.
In the other capital of Romania, we want to introduce technology as a very important argument for the future of our city, for the future of our community. We are a very important city for Romania and for Romanians because here Romania was born as a modern state 100 years ago. But now, through different smart city technologies, we want to make the life of our citizens, of our fellow citizens, happier and easier in the relation with the public authority, with different municipal services, but also with private stakeholders. And we are very happy that we are having a very strong partnership with a company such as Orange, which deploy here in Alba Iulia more than 14 different smart city projects.
So the smart city deployments here are truly fascinating. From buses going around the city taking air pollution readings, to smart street lighting, and even a school solution which allows parents to check their pupils' grades, well, whenever they want, which I'm not sure is an entirely good thing from the kids' perspective. So from Transylvania, it's back to Shanghai where we were last week, and Kavit has got a special report on AI technology.
Artificial intelligence has been a major talking point at Mobile World Congress Shanghai as the industry continues to develop the technology and look at ways that AI can have a real impact on society. At the event, we heard from leaders in the space at the Think AI Summit. Wow, I made some very intelligent new friends on the show floor. Take a look. While many companies showed off the industrial use case of AI-powered robots, one of the most eye-catching innovations on the show floor was Yumi, a coffee-making machine developed by ABB. Yumi was first unveiled 2 years ago and serves a very real-world purpose in pressing the right buttons on a machine to make and deliver a beverage. While ethical concerns around robots such as these and their potential to make the job of a Starbucks worker one day obsolete remain an issue, it must be said that Yumi makes a mean cup of coffee. From making coffee to potentially saving lives, on the Huawei stand, the company showed off a remote surgery robot. Using a 5G connection, a surgeon is able to perform surgery in a different location to the patient. For such a critical use case, high bandwidth and low latency is a major requirement, and such healthcare could enter the mainstream very soon as the 5G era dawns. And finally, our old friend Pepper also made an appearance in Shanghai. Pepper has been busy working with consultancy PwC to develop his skill set for the business world.
Now, Chris has been in Romania with Orange this week, but it's not all smart city services. No, this week we've seen the results of a fixed wireless access trial from Orange, and it's going to be interesting to see how the operator uses fixed wireless access technology to replace fibre services in some of its networks, not just Romania, but potentially across the rest of its European footprint as well. Now, Orange's home country of France has also been in the news this week, right?
Yes, absolutely. French regulator ARCEP has given the green light not just to Orange but SFR as well to expand the 5G tests in new cities. Meanwhile, number three operator Bouygues Telecom has claimed that it has started France's first 5G pilot in real conditions in Bordeaux.
Now, another week, another trade spat between China and the US, and this time it seems that the mega T-Mobile Sprint deal could be affected by the relationship there, because get this, Sprint is owned by SoftBank, of course, and SoftBank has had the audacity of using Huawei equipment in the past. Also, China Mobile's plans to launch in the US have hit a stumbling block as well, so we'll have to wait and see whether that turns out and comes true.
Yes, meanwhile, ZTE, a Chinese vendor, has started making management changes so that it can keep buying from US companies. It announced a new board and a chairman this week, but its worries are far from over because it was meant to get a 600 million euro contract to provide mobile equipment to Italian operator Wind Tre, but Ericsson came in this week and stole the deal.
And talking of Wind Tre, the operator is now 100% owned by CK Hutchison after Hutchison bought out the 50% it didn't own from mobile operator Vion for 2.5 billion euros.
That's all from this week's Mobile Mix. We'll be back next week.